Hey guys, and welcome to today's video. So in today's video, we are going to be talking all things drugstore blush. If you are new to my channel, welcome. I'm Taylor. This is Drugstore Maven, where we talk about all things drugstore beauty. So if that interests you, then go ahead and click that subscribe button and I would love to have you. So with that, let's go ahead and get right into it. All right, this first blush is the most expensive blush I'm going to mention. Obviously still affordable because it is drugstore, but it's on the pricier side, but I really, really think it's worth the price tag. And it is the Honest Beauty Blush. This retails for $13, but like I said, worth every penny. Mine's kind of destroyed because I use it all the time. It has a little compact mirror, so it's perfect to stick in your purse and refresh throughout the day when your mask rubs everything off. It's formulated with all naturally derived fruit extracts. Examples are raspberry, blackberry, and grapefruit extracts. It's hypoallergenic for those of you with very sensitive skin. This is not going to irritate your skin. I have very sensitive skin for those of you that are new here. It's so creamy and so buildable. I use whatever brush I use for my foundation. For example, this one by Real Techniques. After I go in and apply my foundation, I'll use the same brush, just dip it into here and apply. With the first application, it's just gonna look like a flush, just very natural, not intimidating at all if you're new to makeup or new to blushes. I know sometimes cream-based and liquid blushes can be intimidating because you feel like they're just gonna apply all this pigment that you can't get off, but it's not the case with this. It's more on the sheer side, but like I said, it's very buildable. So if you do like a lot of blush, you can just continue packing this on to the whatever intensity you enjoy. This has a dewy finish, so those of you with oily skin, just be aware of that. If you don't set this with a powder, it's definitely going to leave a dewy finish, but like I said, for more natural makeup days where you're not gonna go in with an actual highlighter, it's nice to have a blush that will leave your skin looking radiant and your cheeks looking radiant without any sort of glitter or highlight, just a little bit of light reflection when the sun hits your cheek. I have mine in the shade Rose Pink, and for someone that doesn't typically go for really pinky blushes, this is a really wearable shade of pink. So if you are like me and you like more natural looking blushes, this is more on the nude side and a product that's gonna go with pretty much any makeup look. All right, next up is a newer product to the drugstore. I picked it up to test it out and I was just completely blown away, and I've been obsessed with it ever since, so much so that it made it into this video. And it is the NYX Sweet Cheeks Soft Cheek Tint Blush Mousse. This is a super unique formula. I know for me personally, I'm used to liquid blushes that come out like little drops of pigment. This is like a mousse. It sort of looks like a matte liquid lipstick. That's kind of the consistency of it. It's packaged almost identical to and feels a lot like their soft matte lip creams. It was really kind of weird for me to take this lipstick applicator and apply it to my cheeks and blend it out. But when I did, I was amazed, you guys, because it really is like a mousse. It goes on kind of thick, but as you blend it out, it disappears almost into nothing, but it leaves the sheer tint that it describes. It has more of a matte finish. It's not gonna give you kind of the radiance that this Honest one will. So if you have oily skin and you usually steer clear of any liquid type of products because you need all the powder you can get to control that oil, this would be a really good option. Again, this is very buildable. It goes on, like it says, as a sheer tint. So this can be just the tiniest wash of color, or you can build it up as much as you want. That's typically what I gravitate toward when it comes to blushes, is something that's more buildable. There's nothing worse than finishing all your makeup and then going in with blush and ruining the whole look because it's way too pigmented. So I like something that's blendable, buildable, something that I can mold into the level of intensity that I want. And that's definitely the case with this one. And if I didn't mention it, this one retails for $9, and I have mine in the shade Nude Tude. Very wearable shade, absolutely beautiful formula. All right, next up is not gonna be a surprise to those of you that saw my Best of the Drugstore Bronzers video. I have the corresponding bronzer to this blush in that video, and both of these products are just absolutely incredible and super affordable. This one is the e.l.f. Primer Infused Blush. I have mine in the shade Always Cheeky. It's this really pretty, wearable, peachy shade. It's one of the blushes I have on right now. I have two blushes layered on top of each other. The other one is coming up next. But this is just a absolutely beautiful peachy shade. The thing that I love about this one is the same thing I loved about the bronzer. Even when I wear it with no foundation on, which is usually a requirement for me to have foundation on so that the blush has something to attach to and blend to, kind of have that base down, this goes on beautifully without any sort of foundation, without any sort of BB cream, which speaks volumes to the formula. Because it already has a primer built in, it's almost like you're blending it on top of a primer or on top of a foundation when you go to apply it to your bare cheeks. It's just hard to find in a blush. Because it has a primer, also, it's very long wearing. It starts to fade kind of towards the end of the day, which I would expect from any blush on my oily skin. But by and large, it lasts all day long and is one of the most long wearing blushes I've tried. If you just want a good old fashioned blush to give your cheeks some color, that's gonna perform well, it's gonna last long, this is the one for you. It's a matte finish, perfectly pigmented, no fuss blush that is gonna last you a really long time. All right, so the blush that I have underneath this e.l.f. one on today is this Burt's Bees blush. I've loved this one since back in 2017. I remember talking about it on my channel forever ago when I first tested all of the brand new Burt's Bees makeup. This product blew me away and it still really does. Because of the formula, the ingredients, and this shade is just gorgeous. This is the shade Toasted Cinnamon. Again, I'm not a big pink blush person, which I'm sure you've noticed. I've got like nude mauve-y shades and peachy shades. That's just what I gravitate towards for my skin color, but this also does come in kind of a cool toned pink shade if you have fairer skin than me or do enjoy a pinkier blush. That's also a really, really pretty shade. This is $9.99 and it's 100% made with natural ingredients. So if you're kind of trying to make the transition to more natural products, this is a really good one to add to your collection. It's made with bamboo, honey, and vitamin E. It is very buildable, again, perfect level of pigment, but with this one, you will get some kickback. You will get some of that powdery residue, which I don't get with the e.l.f. one, so just be aware of that. I think it's a small sacrifice to make for a fully natural blush that performs as well as this one does. So when you go to apply it, just make sure you dust off the excess on your brush and then apply it to your face. It's hard to see in the pan, but there is a little bit of a sheen to this blush. If you are someone that doesn't like the texture that you have in your cheek area and you want to keep things matte, definitely choose the e.l.f. one over this one. But if you like a product that's going to give you a little bit of radiance and kind of combine a super natural highlighter with your blush, I think you'll really enjoy this one. So definitely my top pick for a drugstore blush with natural ingredients. All right, so I know I usually try and keep these to 5 products to keep these videos consistent and concise, but I just couldn't choose between these two and they're both from the same brand. So I decided to put them both in the video and just talk about them together. So kind of cheating, but it's a 2-for-1. And they are the Flower Beauty blushes. We've got the Flower Blush Balm in the shade Cinnamon, very similar to that Burt's Bees shade. And then the Flower Pot Blush in the shade Peach Primrose, who surprised a bronzy shade and a peachy shade. That's just always what I go for. I would say out of all of the blushes in this video, this is the most pigmented. So if you want a little bit more pigment and the idea of a really buildable blush isn't your thing, I'd say go with this one. But what I will say is that it's very easily blendable. It's not the type of blush that if you apply a ton of it, it's just gonna stick there and you're kind of screwed with your makeup look. But this one, even if a little bit too much comes off the brush, you can really blend it into your skin and work with it to get the level of pigment that you were looking for. I think this Peach Primrose shade is a really pretty corally shade for those of you with more warm undertones or more olive skin tones. If you have fairer skin, I'd say the shade Sweet Pea might be a really good pick. I think that shade's also really beautiful and a little bit more on the cool tone side. And as far as the blush balm goes, this is one of the original drugstore liquid blushes, and to me, it's still the best one. I also really enjoy the Milani one, but not as much, so it didn't make the video. It's sitting here just in case I change my mind, but I'm trying to stick to my rules. This is one of the only liquid blushes that I've tried that really does not disturb the foundation underneath. When you apply this on top of freshly applied foundation, it's just gonna blend beautifully on top of it. It's not going to rub it off, which I found to be the case with the Maybelline one, the CoverGirl one, the Physicians Formula one. I've tried a ton of cream blushes and this one just can't be beat. If I compare it to the NYX Sweet Cheeks, I would say this is a lot more pigmented. Think of this as like pigment drops where each drop really packs a punch, and think of this as more of a tint where it's a sheer wash of color. This is a much thinner consistency with a lot more density to the pigment. So a little bit of this is gonna go a very long way. And those are all of my very favorite blushes at the moment. So I really hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. It lets me know what types of videos you guys enjoy watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new here, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.